All right, so it's 8:30 this morning. It's the 29th, and we are officially 5 months old today. Of course, this is just Tegan this morning. Amelia actually woke up at about 5:30, so she should actually be getting up shortly to eat again, and I'm going to put her right back to sleep. But little Miss Tegan here, she woke up at 7:30, so I'm kind of trying to keep her up until her sissy wakes up, so that way if I put her in her crib and she cries, she's not going to wake up her sister, because her sister will be already up in with Mommy, getting something to eat. And then hopefully by the time Amelia's done eating, Tegan will be asleep, and I could put Amelia right back into her crib, and Amelia will, usually she goes right back to sleep. Sometimes she cries, but Tegan's pretty good about staying asleep, so. Anyway, it's Thursday, and we're going to be staying upstairs most of today, and she's just watching me talk. And, just because it's easier for me to stay upstairs with my surgery and everything. I did have gallbladder surgery about 2 weeks ago. I had 4 incisions, one at the belly button, one on my chest, and 2 on my by my ribs. And I wasn't allowed to pick up the girls for those 2 weeks. However, I kind of did. So one of my incisions reopened. And so I'm just trying to take it easy. So basically, we're going to stay upstairs today. Just so that way it's easier for me to get them in and out of their cribs and play with them on the bed and clean up our room, because our room is just disgusting. I just love that she's just looking at me. Look at that look. What is that look about? What is that look about? And so while they're taking their morning nap, I'll probably clean up our room, get that situated, or I might take a nap. Either way, we're staying upstairs today. Sebastian will be downstairs with his Nana. And I'm going to put the baby gate up at the stairs so that way he can't really come up here, because I don't want him up here bugging me and then the girls and stuff. And not until Daddy gets home, which Daddy will be home today around 2:30 in the afternoon or a little bit after. So Thursdays and Fridays he goes to work at 6 and stays till 2:30. That's Thursdays and Fridays, and then Monday through Wednesday, he usually goes to work at 2:30 to 11 in the afternoon. So, and then I will be going back to work probably probably about a week and a half. So, I'm not really all that thrilled about it, but that's all right. It is what it is, so I'm going to miss having my mornings with my girls, because it's going to end except for on Saturday and Sundays. Yep. It'll end for a while, so not too thrilled, but gotta make some money, and also I have to go back for a minimum of 30 days, and then I'll probably be there for a couple months, and then I'm gonna quit my job, so, because I don't want to miss out on this. I love this. So anyway, she seems to be getting a little restless. As you can tell, she's now starting to squirm and trying to sit up and get fussy, so we're going to say goodbye for now and probably stream a video, probably of Amelia, because I'm probably going to go just wake her up. Alrighty, so I'll see you in a bit. Or Amelia. Alright, so this is Miss Amelia. It's actually about 8:52 right now, because so Tegan was basically fussing, so I basically thought, okay, she's been up for almost an hour and a half, so she must be getting tired, because no matter what I was doing, she was fussing, so she got wrapped back up in her wrap. And she got put back in her crib. So this is Amelia. And let me turn down the volume on the show here. And she's our talker. I don't know if she'll do it while I have the camera going. You know what she's saying? What's she saying? You want to talk some more? Anyway, she wakes up. She wakes up around like sometimes at 5:30 in the morning instead of later on. So I'll wake up to hearing her on the baby monitor going, just a talking and a talking. And And she does it for like half an hour or so, and then if she's hungry, she starts fussing and starts crying and stuff. But she does that throughout the day, and she's getting to a point where she's almost hungry, because her Really, it's about 9:30, would be 4 hours, so. And she rolled over yesterday. Mommy actually watched, which was pretty cool. Oh. Yeah. She's just a talking away. It's funny to see the differences. It's funny to see the differences between the two of them. They both try to sit up, though. And at 5 months, they're doing pretty good. They both try to sit up, and she's rolling over. And she's talking a lot more than Tegan does. Tegan only does a little bit. And Amelia is just our little GABA. She loves to talk. And obviously she rolled over first, so that was pretty fun, huh? See, that was pretty fun. Huh, was that fun? We think she was actually probably going after a rattle, which was kind of cool. So, because they both enjoy their rattles. My son didn't, so it's different to have, whoop. I'm holding her hand to help her stay up, but she keeps throwing herself backwards. And then they both do this really weird thing where they, it's only weird to me because my son never did it, and where they like to squirm around so much that they actually turn themselves sideways, not roll over, but turn themselves sideways. So she likes to interrupt Mommy a lot. When I'm talking to her, she'll interrupt me with some words. And I love listening to her, so it's not a big deal. But I'm sure she's just going to be our little GABA mouth, huh? Are you just going to be a GABA GABA girl? Yeah. Are you going to be a GABA GABA girl? There's my smile. Hi, honey. Hi. Anyway, so that's Amelia. We're going to go ahead and get off the video camera, and I'm going to take a couple pictures, snapshots of her, and then feed her her bottle. Alrighty, so we'll see you later. You want to say anything? You want to say anything before we go? Say nope. All right.
I'm the one with two left feet standing on a lonely street. I can't even walk a straight line. And every time you look at me, I'm swinging like an autumn leaf, bound to hit bottom sometime. Where would I be without someone to save me? Someone who won't let me fall. You are everything that I live for. Everything that I can't believe is happening. You're standing right in front of me with arms wide open. All I know is every day is filled with hope, 'cause you are everything that I believe. Life within every single beat of my heart. I'm the one with big mistakes, big regrets, and bigger breaks than I'd ever care to confess. Oh, but you're the one who looks at me and sees what I was meant to be, more than just a beautiful mess.